Okay, what we're going to see today is the Miura-Ori or the Miura Fold. And it's an origami that's a tessellation. And it looks like this. So what's really unique about this is that it's actually been used in satellites for folding solar panels. So it can be squeezed down, you know, very tightly and then expanded. Like so. And the compactness is only limited by how far you can actually fold down the material. So it can actually be very tiny, you can imagine in a spacecraft. And then it can be expanded out and pulled. And because it's folded, there's a limited number of motors that are needed to actually pull it out into shape. So we're gonna make this
okay.
Today. So let's start with the flat sheet of paper. And what we're gonna do here is we're just going to fold it. There we go. Get this started. Twice, and this is our third time. There we go. Let's get these folds nice and tight. Okay, let's unfold and take a look. So what we're now going to do is just fold it back and forth on itself now that we've got the creases. There we go. Just make sure those are nice and crisp. Okay, and then first thing we're going to do here is we're going to fold down this corner. So let's do that. Okay, and let's expand it out, and what we'll see here is we'll make these little mountain folds along each of these ridges. There we go, nice and tight. Should look like that. You can see that's the start of our pattern. See that? All right, now we're just gonna start folding up, no kind of a way. And you'll see this pattern just continue the whole tutorial here. We'll get that. Let's get that creased. Okay. And now the trick really is, now that we've kind of got this crease, these are going to reverse. All these mountains and valleys, they're going to flip. Now, so we'll just do it on this end here because we're going to be very careful on this end. We get the fold right. So we'll just kind of get this started over here on this, on the long end, kind of the end that doesn't have this stuff here on the left. And we'll get that going. Kind of get these going the opposite way now. And then back over here, what we'll do is we can kind of see where the fold wanted to go. And we're just gonna kind of help it and guide it and get it going. There we go. There you go. And this one's a reverse. This one needs a little help. This one popped out of place. So there you go. So there's two folds. We can kind of just straighten that up a little bit. And so now the pattern will just continue. You can see that we're starting the little mountains and valleys. So we'll fold this back down. And the same kind of almost looks like a W. Get those as crisp as we can, kind of help that along. Okay, so those are going to want to fold down the opposite direction, so we'll continue like that. And I think what I'll do here is, I think you see where this is going, I think you kind of get the idea. We may swap over to time lapse here so I don't bore you to death with me creating each one of these. But you can see it almost wants to go. You just gotta kind of finesse it, kind of help it, but it'll go. And then you just repeat the pattern all the way up and down. Yeah, you can see right in here it's starting to flatten out. It's giving me a hard time. There you go. Get that guy going. Not very crisp right there. This guy. That guy right there. This guy totally came out. Alright, so I'm going to go to time lapse and we'll do the rest of those and you'll see it complete there and then we'll finish up. I think you can see how the pattern's going. And there you have it. There is the completed product. Let's take a look at him. Let's take a look at him up close. We'll just spin him around. Look at him. Look at that. So here's kind of a close. It almost reminds me of the way an egg carton feels with its 3D kind of you know, feel with minimal amount of material. That's it. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please remember to like, subscribe, and share. Hi, Otis. Otis is like, they're getting all the attention over there.